Les has made progress in accepting his parents' death, but the therapists know that there are deeper problems to address.
Is it something you don't want to talk about? It's not, no. I don't know what happened, but it's not that you prefer not to talk about with the cameras on?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. But it's not like I don't want to talk about it anymore. It's just like, fuck it. I've forgiven myself. It wasn't my fault. I wasn't to blame. And I'm not going to carry that guilt around.
How old were you?
I was about 17.
And you won't talk about them because?
I just won't. It's too personal.
What's around that? No, I don't want you to talk about it if you don't, but what's about it? Because it feels too hurtful, embarrassing?
Hurtful, embarrassing.
Shameful, yeah. Maybe?
Shameful.
Okay. So at some point, I would encourage you, especially if there's shame involved, to talk about it. Because that's the stuff that you want to let go of.
Away, yeah.
The shame.
Well, if we get a chance, we could maybe go there, but I'm not looking forward to it. It's going to be pretty tearful.
You know what? It'll feel good.
Yeah. Could we have a one-on-one without all the technology?
I think we can just take off the mics and you can tell me, you know, talk to me for 10 minutes.
Yeah. I don't think it's going to be a 10-minute job.
You can talk to me for 20 minutes.
I don't think it's going to be a 20-minute job.
But I think for you, just to say it.
Yeah, but, you know, can we? I'd like us to be alone.
Okay, it's time.
So we were talking there today, and there was one in particular thing that I just couldn't speak about in kind of public kind of thing. And so we switched the cameras off and we had a little chat to ourselves. And I was able to talk to her, and I was quite surprised at how easy I could get something that's been quite bothering me for, you know, since I was like 17, and how easy I could just let it out. There you go, it's not a fucking secret anymore.
It's the weekend, and the group is taking a break from the clinic and heading to the mountains.
So the purpose of this experience is to be able to have the opportunity to walk into a scary place, a place of challenges and a place of maybe fear, and to be able to work through that.
In therapy, Les has spoken about trauma he hasn't dealt with for decades. It's been a liberating experience and left him in a buoyant mood, ready to tackle the ropes course.
There you go, 1, 2, 3.
Go, Les!
It's all right, we can do this. We can do this. Ready? To the left, to the left.
It actually helps when you lean into it more.
Move as far as you can.
I'm too far. You're good.
I'm gone. Look at that.
Oh, I'm shaking.
You were there for me, though. That was great.
With Alicia and Les back on solid ground.
Fucking
windy.
Don't
look down.
It's time for the others to take to the ropes.
You've got to trust the other person completely.
Trust not only the other person in the team, it's an arena.
And also, you don't want to let the other person down, so you're like, right, I'm going to do this, because there's two of you in it. We could
trust and in cooperation.
And got over our fear, because it was really scary. I was shaking like anything.
But you know, when you look at it from down here, it doesn't look that much, but once you get up there, you go, oh, God, no.
The ropes course has helped the group bond. Now it's time for Laurie to use this newfound trust and ask them to discuss their feelings on one another's recovery.
I think it's pretty cool that I made new friends.
It's good though here because we've got things in common with somebody. I especially relate to you two because it's drinking. And you're an inspiration. No, because you drink more than me, or you have drunk more than me. And it shows, you know, you're looking great already. So I'm looking at you and thinking, God, they look great and they're doing it. I can do it too.
Well, thank you.
I'm better looking for the money.
How you doing?
Don't say to me I'm walking.
Oh, Les is a sweetheart. He's just such a sweet man. I feel really sorry for him as well, because sometimes you can really see the struggle that he's going through.
I've just seen him, he's like another man, completely. And it's so lovely, he's such a lovely, lovely guy. I've got such a soft spot for Les. And, you know, I thought he was lovely to start with when he was drinking, but then, you know, watching him and seeing how strong he's been and how positive, and I really think Les is going to do it forever. I really believe he's not going to drink anymore.